Hi, Ms.Sheila! Welcome back again! Alam mo naman! Come in!
Hi, Ms.Sheila!
Morning, morning!
Hi, Ms.Sheila! Hello! Next seat!
Welcome, welcome!
Have a seat!
May kuryente ako minsan eh!
Malakas ang chemistry ni Ate Ben. Good morning.
Parang nakikita ko yung mga donya sa ano, sa
donya. TV.
Good morning.
Good morning, everyone. Great to be back.
Ano ba ang usapan natin ngayon, Ms. Sheila?
Continuation ba ito ng topic mo last?
Oh, kasi it's a truly comprehensive subject, no, yung self-care. Ngayon, ang pag-uusapan natin, mind and body connection.
Sige.
Yes, and how
mind
these two...
Mind and body connection.
And how these two are integrated because they're one functioning unit and not separate entities. Kasi ang iisipin natin, yung maayos ka sa conditioning ng katawan mo, physical well-being, okay na lang, relax ka na lang. But you actually have to work on the well-being of your mind. Because the mind... is the one that is functioning when it comes to emotions and feelings that are manifested in the physical.
Yes.
Ako, I concentrate more on the heart.
Ang heart naman, it has something to do also with the mind, pero it's a physical part of the body, right? For instance, kuya, kunyari in love, o ano yung nararamdaman mo pag in love ka?
Masaya.
Happy.
Masaya.
Happy.
Kayo lagi.
You are motivated to do more, di ba? You are able to concentrate. So, love is actually a feeling. Ang love, when it's physicalized, medyo mas maganda yung concentration mo. How about pag natatakot or ninenerbios?
Di ka mapakali.
Yeah.
Para ang gulo ng isip mo.
At ang tawag, di ba, yung butterflies in the stomach. But, so may physical manifestation, lahat ng feelings.
So, paano yung relationship feeling ng ano, prioritizing yung self-care kasama yung mind and body mo? Paano yun, Ms.Sheila?
Well, you have to consider the two as functioning unit. Therefore, everything that you do should be integrated.
Kasi others would always say, ang unang isip nila, ang unang thinking nila pag sinabing self-care, yung kunyari, papagandahin yung sarili, having time for yourself, pero it is more than that, di ba, Ms. Sheila? So, paano yun? Paano magkakaroon ng self-care over your mind and body?
Okay. When you're in your right state of mind, given that you address all the physical areas, for instance, tama ba yung tulog mo? The right number of hours of sleep? Exercise. Ano yung sunod? Diet.
Naku, diet.
Kaya pala naman nasa isip.
Wala yun kasi talaga sa isip.
Thank you for the reminder. I needed that.
Lagi na nakakalimutan
yun. And then, of course, healthy habits and hobbies para meron ka namang outlet. And all of those, among many other things, when you're able to do them, you become more motivated to function well. Kasi yung mind mo,
or clear of negative thoughts, diba, and other,
correct,
ano pa ba? Stress-induced
thinking. May clarity
thinking
of thinking ka, oo. And you are inspired to do more. Kahit yung pagbabasa, diba, it feeds your brain, but it's actually something that you end up actualizing pag naiplano mo ng tama yung gagawin mo, na-prioritize mo yung mga schedule mo, yung mga goals mo, kasi mas informed ka.
Yan. Ms. Sheila, ano ang mangyayari na yung worst case scenario kapag hindi mo na pagsama yung iyong mind at yung body sa self-care? Kapag hindi mo sila pinag-join forces?
If there's a disconnect between how you look after yourself in terms of the physical and the mental, you will not function well. Kasi talagang dalawang yan sabay. You cannot even say that, oh, I take care of my body, therefore, I become more mentally intelligent. Or I'm reading a lot, therefore, kaya ko nang binabasa ko lahat about fitness, therefore, makukondisyon ko na yung sarili ko. So, magtutulungan yan. Parang left and right hands mo, working together.
I was wondering, Ms. Sheila, ano-ano yung mga activities or let's say, ano ba, mga trainings or workshop that we can do to improve yung mind and body na, para, yun nga, para masama dun sa self-care.
Anything that makes you feel more motivated and inspired mm-hmm. and determined to keep going is a good avenue or outlet. So, if you're the type of person who gets more motivated by reading or meditating, ano pa ba yung mga exercises mo na
kailan minsan, di ba sabi nga nila, as simple as staying away from the negative factors people, that contribute to the negative feelings that you have would be sufficient enough.
Tama yan, Angel. Kaya isang segment ng topic na to is mindfulness. Because if we talk about psychology, it's about studying how we should observe situations. Pero ang psychology, hindi yan masyadong napagtutuunan kung sino yung nag-o-observe, mm-hmm. the person experiencing the situations. And definitely, if we consider mindfulness, you will stay away from those situations and people who do not allow you to thrive. So do not get involved too much with people and situations that do not allow you to evolve. Yan yung mindfulness. Matuto ka rin mag-isip sa sarili mo kung ano yung tama at ano yung mali. Hindi lahat ng nababasa mo tama, hindi lahat ng naririnig mo aayunan mo. Because after
parang
all,
learning how to say no din, ano?
Yes.
Learning how to say no and how to be critical mm-hmm. in your thinking process. For instance, alam mo na antibiotic is good, pero hindi ka naman iinom ng antibiotic oras-oras. Sinabi sa'yo nung doktor, get a second opinion. Because if you're in full control of how you're feeling and your mind is clear, alam mo kung ano yung dapat mong itetake. So scrutinize also kung ano yung mga payo na naibibigay sa'yo, kung ano yung mga advice na naririnig mo, because there's no cookie cutter approach to mind and body wellness. Iba-ibang tao, iba-ibang disposition, iba-ibang perspectives. And at least 80% of what works for us has to do with our conditioning. Eh.
Mm-hmm.
If you decide to get better by exercising, nandun na. Everything about you will work mm-hmm. para ma-enjoy mo yung exercise. But if you're not the type of person who is used to exercising more than 10 minutes a day, tapos bigla kang nag-isang oras,
mm-hmm.
isang linggo.
Sakit ng katawan.
Sakit ng katawan, yes.
Mabibigla ka.
At mabibinat ka, di ba?
Mm-hmm.
And you will definitely have this feeling of, you will distance yourself.
Parang
from,
ayaw mo na.
From that, oo. So, mindfulness is about listening to your body.
Mm-hmm. At saka, I think one of the most important things also to learn yung sinasabi nila, Ms. Sheila, na accepting na there's something wrong sometimes. Kasi, di ba, kapag yung iba, hindi may denial pa.
Yes.
Kunyari, hindi naman ako na-apektuhan dyan, eh, ganyan. Pero yung lahat ng work, kunyari, yung workload mo affected na with how you feel, di ba, at a certain situation. But because you're not aware or sometimes you're in denial, hindi mo na-address yung main concern.
Mm-mm. And that's the point of looking after ourselves. Initially, ang pag-aaralan mo paano mapabuting sarili mo based on how you're feeling.
Mm-mm.
But eventually, it affects how you look at situations. May evaluate mo kung ano yung tama, kung ano yung mali, kung ano yung ayon, kung ano yung sobra. And yes, you have to listen to your body. You have to listen to your feelings.
Mm-mm.
If you sense that something is wrong or off and something is not working well for you. Mm-hmm.
Pero how will you differentiate it, say for example, para masabi mo na you're not being selfish at all? Kasi baka sabihin naman nila na you're always looking after yourself. Eh, what about the others? Diba? Eh, sabi nga nila, love the others as well. Pero paano? Paano mo madi-differentiate at masasabi na I'm not selfish by self-caring?
Well, self-care does not actually make you selfish.
Mm-hmm.
It's a selfless act because it's something that you do for the people you love. You take care of yourself and you can take care of them even better. Siyempre, may tao talagang selfish. Pero na yun, disposition yun, nasa character yun. And it's a choice that that person makes. And most likely, there's a disconnect. Kasi kung selfish ka, and you're working only for yourself, short term ka lang, hindi ka inclusive, then there's something in your brain that will not work properly when it comes to setting long-term goals, you know, when it comes to looking at the big picture, setting priorities based on what's truly important. Mako-compromise yan.
But speaking of long-term and short-term na sinabi mo, Ms.Sheila, parang how will you tell yourself or somebody who's practicing self-care na gawin niya ito for a long-term situation? Kasi baka mamaya, because this is just a fad na, di ba parang kasi ngayon lang nauso supposedly yung, I mean, people know about self-care, pero ngayon talaga mas napag-uusapan. Di ba? So, paano mo masasabi sa isang tao na, paano magagawa ng isang tao na maging committed siya into self-care for a long period of time?
Yeah. Well, you're right, Angel, no? Hindi naman to bago. Ngayon lang na pag-uusapan. Mm-hmm. Self-care, we can consider it a universal truth. Pag-truth kasi, hindi naman yan trend eh.
Mm-hmm.
From time immemorial, talagang basahin mo yung mga classical literature, nandiyan na. Exactly. You have to learn to take care of yourself so you can take care of the people around you. How do we convince someone who is not concentrated on that? Just take it a day at a time. Kasi paunti-unti until it becomes a habit, until it becomes you. You cannot force something that is not in your system. Eh. Kailangan makondisyon muna yung sarili mo that it's right for you, and you sense the difference that it makes in your life, in your decision making, how you view problems, how you handle crisis situations. Then you will be motivated to learn more, to become more, to plan better. Kung ano yung mga makakatulong sa'yo, you keep adding. Ang tawag dun sa learning schematic.
Mm-hmm.
So you start with step one, and then you keep building step two. And do not rush the process. Because self-care is supposed to be enjoyable.
Mm-hmm.
Buhay mo yan eh. Diba?
Mamaya na pe-pressure lang siya na everybody's doing self-care. I should
Naki-uso.
Self-care also, no? Pero I was wondering, Ms.Sheila, no? Kasi parang, yun nga, napag-uusapan natin, matagal naman na talaga tong self-care na to. Pero ano, what could be the possible reason but all of a sudden, everybody's into self-care? Meron bang something right now in our situation, in our generation, mm-hmm. na talagang nag-trigger ng kailangan ng isang tao ay magkaroon ng self-care?
Well, our orientation now is towards what is beautiful, eh.
Mm-hmm. Diba?
Sa social media, super positive, tapos super beautiful, lahat extreme. And so I think it's good na na-channel yun towards self-evaluation, kung ano ba yung ginagawa ko na tama, kung ano yung kailangan kong i-adjust, kung ano yung mali. At the same time, we have to be wary of comparing ourselves to whatever or whoever we see online. Syempre naman, pag naka-Instagram na, may mga editing na yan.
Filtered.
Mga filter.
Literally and figuratively.
Yes. In your day-to-day life, hindi ka naman pwedeng mag-filter. Wala namang pang-spray. Para biglang maging ano ka, super flawless pagising sa umaga. So we have to be realistic about it. But truly, you should be grounded on what works well for you.
Okay.
And if you're mindful, another way of saying mindful is if you're thoughtful, di ba, iisipin mo talaga, pakikinggan mo yung katawan mo, pakikinggan mo kung ano yung tama, di ba, and i-evaluate mo kung ano yung nasasagap mo sa paligid mo and online, then you will be guided better on the decisions that you're going to make, whether it's in terms of your diet, what you wear, what you do, yung self-discipline, yung self-control. If something does not feel right, babawasan mo ba or tatalikuran mo na? Diba parang ano lang yan eh?
Parang pagkain lang yan.
Tasabi ko sana parang relationship. Pagkain
lang. Stay.
Yung mga talks. Baka may advice ka, Ms.Sheila, dun sa mga first-timers na gusto din nilang mag-try nitong self-care.
Well, it's it's a concept, self-care, and a reality at the same time. It's open to everyone. You don't have to be enrolled to a certain program. Mm-hmm. But if you need intervention, definitely you consult advisors or people who know better, like health experts, medical professionals. But my biggest suggestion is listen to your body and evaluate what you're getting yourself into. Ikaw ang mas makakapag-decide, ikaw makakapag-evaluate better what is good for you and what is proper for the occasion. In the end, self-care is something that you do not only for yourself but for the people you love so that you can be a better person every day.
Ayun. Yun.
Thank you so much, Ms.Sheila Viesca.
Ms.Sheila.
Ms.Sheila, saan po ba ulit ang TalkShop?
Ang TalkShop is located in Makati, Salcedo Street, Legazpi Village. And you can get in touch with us at 894-5588-0917, 877-5588. This summer, throughout the year, we have courses in personal effectiveness, public speaking, creative writing, coaching, and many more.
So meron din pang kids?
For kids also.
Na rin.
Oo. Yung mga kids, pwede na sila for public speaking and even writing because we usually have integrated learning techniques.
Ayo.
That's great.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, Ms.Sheila.